In this video, we got some underground action. We're just gonna risk it for the biscuit and go for those big cash outs. So yeah, I really love this trait. Either you go first or eighth, but yeah, that's what makes it kind of exciting, right? It's like mercenaries from set 6, but I guess with a little bit less of a risk, but I mean, it's still fun. You get pretty addicted to this trait, at least I do. Once you play it once, you just get a big cash out and you're hooked on it. But yeah, we're just kicking it off here with these random units, none of which are important right now. It's just the underground what we're looking for. Of course, I didn't know this just at this moment, but yeah, we're gonna pivot into it as soon as possible. Like, every time I get a chance to play it, I just pivot into it, but I actually decided to reroll these augments and go for the Celestial Blessing. You should never reroll like a tier 1 augment, but I just did it there for the LOLs. I suppose we're just risking it all today with the underground and with rerolling stuff for no reason. That's how we like to play. So we're playing Gadgeteen here. I love this opening as well, but yeah, we're pretty weak compared to this dude anyways, so we're gonna lose this. I think this Fiora is kinda popping off, man, with the Ginsu's, just infinite healing with those autos. Hopefully we can kill her so we save some HP at least. Ah, come on, man. Elisha has like 1 HP. Ay, ay, ay. But it's all cool, cause we have that loss, so I decided to just throw out my entire board and put in the underground. Finally. And we put in a Galio there as well, so we can get that civilian. Get some mana regeneration for our boy Ezreal right here, so we hopefully can kill some units and preserve some HP. So that's the general plan with Ezreal, just for underground, you just wanna lose streak for Econ, but you wanna kill some units and... Okay, this survived like 1 HP, but yeah. The killing unit port isn't going too well, I seem to understand here. This guy seems pretty weak though. Hopefully we can kill his frontline at least. That will be pretty good. Yeah. Did you see that cow snipe right there? Just attacked from the entire board. Alright. Oh, the Oxford is kind of tilting, man. Like when you play against it and then you survive with like 1 HP. Oof. We love Oxford. And that's a tier. Very nice. We're just going for the AP store. Yeah. We're just gonna put it on Ezreal. We get that Archangels. Hopefully we can get like a blue buff or something like that. This guy seems pretty strong though. We're gonna get completely wiped here. I mean, looks like a fast 8 angle. No cap. We're going fast 8. Well, this dude seems pretty strong, even though it's like bot 6. It's all good though, we're gonna level up because we can make Econ anyways. Hopefully we can kill like one unit at least. That will make me happy. But yeah, we're kinda focusing this Rene. And this dude seems to be pretty tanky. As well as Nyla is healing him up as well. Oof. Yeah, we got pretty wrecked there. All good though. Where we got the first heist, but we're gonna say bye-bye to that. Not good enough. We're going for those big cash outs. That's not acceptable. 5 gold. Come on, buddy. We can do better than that. So, see what the Krugs give us. Last Whisper. Ah, maybe we can make a static. Seems better. And we're just gonna make order here. Boom. And we got the Ezreal 2 star now, as well as with early set here, so we might actually be able to pivot into some Mecha Prime set front line with some like AP carry in the back. So that's my plan, just for now, but we'll see how the game turns out. it's actually my placement game, so you know, at this spot I'm not really worried. I kind of like this opening, to be honest. But yeah, if we go first a fast ape, I mean, I'm gonna be stuck in the low ranks then, because you get like a lot of AP in the promo, so you kind of wanna win them so you don't have to go iron, you know. But yeah, I'm really excited to like just hit a big climb this set. I don't know, I'm just feeling this set, to be honest. I didn't really like set 7 that much, but this feels like in my set. More like it's more like set 6, you know. And no weird losses and dragons as well. That's what we like to see. Boom. Okay, this guy was actually pretty weak, so we actually lost our lose streak here, so that's not that good. I mean, we're not gonna be able to win streak unless, I mean, we just hit an echo right here, so that's pretty good, with a rel as well, so we could possibly transition into like a Star Guardian board right here. I mean, we have static that is good on Kai'Sa. We got an Archangel that's good on Talia, so that's kind of my plan at this point. So we might just have to dish the like set plan and go for the Echo plan instead. I like that. Oh, look at that Fjord, though. She's gonna be really tanky. Look at that. Oh, come on, Ezreal. Gonna let him survive with 1 HP. Oh, that big Q right there. Never mind the Oxforest. Come on, man. That's illegal. I don't know, man. Something with Oxforest that just triggers me. But it's all good. We're gonna win this round. It's all good. So here I was kind of like unsure what I wanted to pick. Because, you know, we're kind of dizzy at this point, so I really have no idea. But I decided to just go for the Rod. So we can get like UA Gauntlet. That's good on Kai'Sa as well. Yeah. So we just get that crit on her abilities and autos. So for now, our item holder Ezreal is gonna get that item. Should be good. Get some more crits on his abilities. Oh, look at that Rankster. He's jumping away with 1 HP, man. That's kind of illegal. Everyone's just surviving 1 HP. Come on, bro. Good thing we have a static shift then. It's actually so funny. The Jinx just runs away with the Prankster, and then she runs right back in for the time that Ezreal shoots his ability, and she just runs for straight into her death. So, let's see. Yeah, there's probably a level up angle. Can put in Kai'Sa for the Star Guardian, and we sell everything else later, so we make 40. So basically we lose 1 econ for recon and for Star Guardian, so I like that trade. Seems like a good exchange. Should make us a bit more stronger as well. Give Ezreal some more crit chance with the recon, so that combined with the UA Gauntlet is very nice. I think we're gonna lose this though. And this is so funny, look at this Ezreal. Just jump straight into the guy. Just flashes into the melee carry. That's what we'd like to see. Sometimes the like recon dashes are kind of a troll. But sometimes it's really good. It's kind of a gamble, you know, with the RNG. So we got a lot of golden units there. So I'm just holding on to a lot of stuff here to see what we play. Like, I'm not entirely sold on what to play at this point, actually. But we're getting a lot of 4 costs, so I'm just holding them to see what we hit. I don't think it's Zed because we have 80 items, so probably not Zed, so we can sell Zoe and Zed. We can possibly play MF. I mean, Zac is always good. Belveth, I don't think we're playing her. Yeah. But I'm so dizzy, you know? It's a new set. You don't really know what to do. You're not too familiar with everything. So yeah. Here I decided to go for the Chrono Break Echo Hero Augment. Just so we get that CC. We have a lot of damage, right? So we just want that 2 second stun so we survive for a bit longer. So our carries can just annihilate enemy boards. So, I mean, I guess we could take the Kai's Augment, but I was like not entirely sure that we were even playing her. So I decided to just go for the Echo one. Seems pretty good. 2 second stun, I mean, that's a long time in TFT. Yeah, look at that. That's very nice. Ooh, that Viego though. Kind of scary. Viego is really cracked, man. It was like real bad in the PB beginning. But then they just nerfed everything except the Viego. And they buffed him instead. So yeah, Viego is pretty good. And that's a 2-star sack. Don't mind if I do. 2-star stack, I mean, it's always good. Just get a lot of frontline. Stay hydrated. Pro tip. Oh, look at that Viego though, just annihilating my backline. Hopefully the recon can dash away here. Okay, the recon came in clutch right there. I'm taking everything back that I said on recon previously. About recon, rather. Ooh, hopefully we win this. He only has a B absorb, right? Alright, buddy. That doesn't seem completely balanced, or is it just me? Zero item Viego against like 3 units and a 3 item unit just winning pots. And okay, look at this dude, man. Why am I getting flamed for no reason? So I just had to hit him with the nice A. Come on, the TFT community usually is so nice. Like compared to the League community, but sometimes there's like this one guy who's just flaming for no reason. But yeah, you just need to not care about it and move past. But yeah, now I have some incentive to win right here. Now I have to win because yeah, we have a clear enemy right here. So we have some pretty good items here for Kai'Sa. Aginsu's and Giant Slayer, those are two like BIS items on her, I would say. And we just decided to go for the Defender emblem right here. It took a long time for me to figure out, but yeah, there's a lot of AD players and we have a Rel, so that armor would will come in clutch right here. I think Mord kind of sucks, so we're gonna remove him actually. We already have a Shred, like MR Shred with Step Chip, so we don't need that from Mordekaiser as well. So yeah, we're just gonna sell him right there. And we're actually at 6 Kai'Sas right now. And here I'm just very dizzy. So for some reason I put in Jax. I thought I was gonna do like Mecha Prime for some reason. It wasn't the play, but yeah, come on. We're learning. We're learning. I'm too dizzy right now, but it's all good. If we lose this round, it's all on me. I did a big int right there, but we good, you know, we have 38 HP. Isn't that infinite HP? Can't lose. Alright, 30 HP. I mean, that's enough HP for me to go first, right? But yeah, I think we're gonna transition into like a 5-star Guardian board instead. With Atalia and a Kai'Sa duo carry. Because we have those AP items from Ezreal right there. So those are gonna be really good on Atalia. As well as a static Shiv just being amazing on Kai'Sa, of course. Because she has Ginsu's. And she only autos, so she's gonna proc those lasers a lot. Very nice. Now we're just gonna roll it. And we actually hit a Syndra right there, so we're saying bye-bye to the mechs. We're gonna put in those 5-star Guardians. Now we're gonna put on those AP items, lovely. And Of course, we're going for that Bramble right here, because everybody's playing AD. And boom, look at that Talia ulti right there. Mind you, she's only one cost right here, and she didn't ramp up Archangels, so she's gonna do some big numbers later. Boom. So yeah, let's see, we have Kai'Sa now. We only need a few more Kai'Sas. We're gonna put in Piddle here, just put him in the front line so he gets that instant CC off. So yeah, take a look at this. I think this is like the best strategy for Fiddle, is put him in the front so he CCs. I don't like the strat where you put him in the back. I don't think it's gonna use it. Okay, never mind. He's just standing AFK in the front line. I mean, that works as well. But yeah, I think it's better to put him in the front line so he's insta cast the CC. I don't think it's like better to make him get more AP by letting your units die, you know, his corrupted passive. I think it's kind of a bait, to be honest. Yeah, we're actually at 3 star Kai'Sa right there, and we're at 6 attacks. Okay, we're actually in a good spot here. This underground kind of paid off, right? Oh, and that Syndra just grabbed in another 2-star 4-cost sack. Yeah, Syndra is fun. Boom. Let's see here. So, I had like 2 options here, I would say. Either I go for like a Gargoyle, or I go for the Ginsos. Yeah, I decided to just go for the Ginsos because it's basically like a Spear Soldier on Syndra, right? She just autos more, gets more mana from more autos. She brings in more units, so yeah, I think it's good. She's just gonna ramp up the mana regeneration combined with the Star Guardian. That's gonna be very good. Ooh, the Zed just jumped into my Talia though. Ouch. But seems like his entire team died, so it's all good. The Zed was just generating my Talia mana, right? I don't actually think Aegis is the way to go this game, because everybody's AD, so I'm gonna need to find something else than Aegis. Boom. So Kai'Sa is actually really good in this matchup, because she is good against those high HP targets, and she even has a Giant Slayer, so she's gonna tear through that DX, as well as Talia is the deleting all the small units with her AoE. So that's like pretty nice combo. Talia just kills the small units, and Kai'Sa kills the tanks with the big HP numbers. So I really like this board actually, I think it's pretty good. The key is just building like an insane front line, which I kind of have. Combined with like Syndra, just bring in more units into the board. So even if they get through the front line, I'm gonna have more front line. So these were some pretty bench options, so I decided just to go the lame route and go for the Shroud actually. I mean, we're facing separate players, so we're gonna have to even out the board and bring that Shroud into play. So decided to just put in another Aegis there for some reason. For some reason. At least we got a Shroud there on like his entire team. And boom. Big Talia ulti right there. That Leon ulti actually came in pretty clutch. Boom. So now it's just Draven left. Hopefully we can melt through him. Come on, Kai'Sa. Go crazy. Whew. That was kind of close, man. A bit close, I would say. Alright, let's see what we hit here. So we're actually pretty close to a 3-star sack. That would be pretty poggers. Let's see if we can hit it. I mean, that would be a pretty insane start to the set, you know. Being a 3-star sack. Okay, we're actually 1 away. Alright, let's see it. Still rolling a bit slow because we don't know what the units look like. But slowly and surely we're gonna roll the money down. I'm kind of skipping Fiddly so Syndra can bring him in. Just so we get like nice CC with him. And yeah, this dude. I lose right here. So we're actually in the top 4s right now. So let's see if we can hit that sack right there. Come on. Ooh, with a Syndra though. So we're 1 Syndra away. We're 1 sack away. We're at 6 Echoes. 5 Talias. So yeah, we have some options to hit here actually. We're so close to everything though. Feels bad. But this is the sack player against, or sack player, the Jax player, so it's gonna be an easy matchup. We might actually kill him here because they changed like player damage, so you take more player damage now. So the game should be a bit shorter, but I feel like the games are longer. Boom, bitch. So we're actually in the finals right here. So we're against the Draven player, right? So I think it's a pretty clear choice what we take right now. Take your guesses. Of course, it's the Bramble Vest. Yeah, we just need to mitigate those crit and the AD numbers, right? So now we just really have to roll it down and pray that we hit an upgrade. Because we're not gonna be able to go 9. And yeah, there we have it. Okay, there's no way we lose now, right? With the sack restore? Surely, surely. Alright, I'm not worried. Of course we're gonna win this. No way we lose this. Let's see it. Nice Talia ulti. We just need the Kai'Sa to ramp up, but okay, it's actually looking a bit closer. Huh? Okay, look at those 4 sacks. Alright, now we're good. Oh, wait. Alright, buddy. Alright, buddy. Somehow we actually lost that, okay? We won against him without the 3-star sack, but once we get the sack, we lose. Okay then. I see how it is. Okay, but he changed his positioning, so maybe we win by him getting another position here. That's what I'm praying for. And we get Echo applying that Sunfire. So we're gonna burn through that big mecha HP. So that's really good. Okay, it's looking a bit more in our favor this time. Alright. Hopefully Kai'Sa can just melt through him right now. That was a big Tali ult as well. Oof, come on. Alright. There we have it. So we're both basically at 1 HP right now, so it's all gonna come down to this next fight. Let's see if we can pull it off. So is there really anything more we can hit? I mean, Echo, but yeah, I think the odds of us hitting a 3-star Echo as well is pretty low. Let's see. I'm kind of picking up some. Okay, alright, we actually hit the 3-star Echo. Alright, and another Bramble Vest. All the good things are free, I suppose, so yeah, another Bramble for our boy Zach right here, and we're just gonna pick up that Echo now. And I don't know, we don't really have another unit to play, so I just put in another Syndra. Why not? So let's see, hopefully we win this fight. Maybe I should just have Champ duplicator so we get another unit put in, but it's all good. Alright, it's an easy win right here. Wait, how is Echo doing the most damage? I thought it was a tank. Alright, buddy. But yeah, that's gonna be our first place. That's what we like to see. Now, thank you guys so much for watching. If you enjoyed this video, be sure to subscribe for more TFT Set 8 content. Yeah, appreciate you watching and have a great one, everybody. Peace out.